Welcome everybody to another one of my videos, and in this one it's time to make something. Now, in reinventing the wheel and electricity, this was the first machine I made. I was probably a little bit ambitious, but we'll go in chronological order of things I made, so let's rebuild this one. So the first thing we're going to make is the pulley, and we're going to need a piece of wood and make a hole per usual and go through the process as in the pulley making tutorial, which is on the screen there. So there we have the pulley. Next we'll make the pinion, which is that small cog in here, and it's going to look something like that. So I'm now going to take a broomstick and make sure it's nice and cylindrical. Now I'm going to take a strip of paper, and on that piece of paper I've decided I'm going to make my teeth 6 millimeters in spacing. So I'm going to mark out every 6 millimeters to get myself like a ruler, so that when I wrap my piece of paper around there, this broomstick is going to line up. Now if it doesn't line up, you then have to shrink it. So yes, it is lining up, so I'm going to then mark those every 6 millimeters around. Now if this is not the right diameter, I've got to reduce that in diameter so that it does match up precisely. Now with it in the vise, I'm going to use a saw and cut between, exactly halfway between each of those marks. So it finishes sort of like that. So now I'm carefully going to take a triangular file, run it down the cut to open the cut in a V without, as it'll open out until it's just reaching the pencil mark. So that now we have this. Now with a couple hacksaw blades, I'm gonna go in there, and with the teeth going backwards, I'm gonna put it into the groove and just flatten out and give a bit more depth to it, to the grooves, and then with the file continue until I have got right to almost getting rid of those pencil lines, but not quite. So it finishes something like that, and then on those tips I'm going to have it so that it's a square at the bottom, up, and then to a point. So I'm going to take off, at the moment it's a little bit like square, I'm just going to round those off with the file. Right, then I'm going to find the center of that and drill a hole through. In a miter box, I'm going to use it as a guide to then cut off about the first couple of centimeters square. So there we have the pinion, but I'm going to use the file just to clean up those so that they're straight, so that those teeth look the same as those teeth, meaning that the teeth that way will be parallel and they won't be wedge shaped. So there we are. And you need to be very careful that you don't pressurize it and snap those teeth. And that's basically why we did them on the broomstick and then cut it off, because the teeth basically tend to break off if you do them straight on here. The pressure on it just snaps them. And then I'm going to put a shaft in there of a nail, and then it's going to go on there and glue it with a bit of glue. And now the main cog. We're basically going to take a piece of plank, the same thing, cut our circle, mark it off there, find the center, drill a hole, make our circle, and ready for cutting the teeth. So there we have our wheel roughed out. Now we're going to take the strip of paper that we did with the 6mm increments on and wrap it around the wheel to see how close we are to the diameter that we are going to need, so that we can get the teeth perfectly spaced, or at least perfectly in the degree that we're doing this anyway. And I can see we're half a tooth out, so I'm going to have to shrink it just a little bit so that those lines line up. And there we have it lined up. It reduced it to line up there, and now we're going to transfer all of those lines onto the wheel. And with the square also, I'm going to draw the lines across and also down towards the center like that, so that I can have two points of reference just in case I have the line for the center to file up to, and if I happen to misjudge, then I still have that point of reference there. Next, I'm going to cut halfway between the two lines from one side, and then also from the other side, and then join the two to make a cut parallel right down the center of those lines, right round. And the same as with before, with the triangular file, we're going to open those up, moving it out towards those pencil marks. Now, so that the edge of the teeth don't chip out, I've filed from one direction on an angle, back the other direction on an angle, and then across straight. Next, I'm going to get in there with a double blade, just open up the bottom of that and make it deeper, and then continue with the filing, just as the same with the pinion. So there we are, the teeth should go nicely in between and spin. Okay, now we're ready to assemble it. Now, having got our cogs done, we need a stand to put it on, and I've got a stick, and I want enough room to put the big cog, the small cog, and the motor below that, and then this little block here. So I've made it basically that long, and I need another block that's going to go from there to support the pulley, and I'm going to screw that one on there. Then I'm going to put the small one on top of there and decide where I'm going to put my pulley, and drill a hole right through this one, the top one, and right through the bottom one at the same time, so that you get the holes in exactly the same place. I'm going to nail that one through there, but I'm going to screw those on because we will need to take those on and off occasionally to replace the rubber band that goes from the pulley to the motor. So there we have that. Okay, now we're going to put the big cog in there, just put it in so that it engages the teeth, and then centralize it, and then we're going to screw it down there. Now, if all goes well, it should just spin around in there, but occasionally you get a tooth that's a little bit tight, and so if you find, isolate that tooth, like one that's just about there, bring it out and just file it and make it so that it's going to go through better. Okay, so you just want to fine tune it now. Now I'm going to put the motor there, and so I'm going to make a wooden clamp by putting it on a piece of wood and cutting out around there like a clamp that's going to hold it down. I've cut it out, now I need some holes to screw it down. And there it is in place with its rubber band and everything, its wires out the back, and we just need to put this other stick on, and we're just about done. So there we have it. We have an LED connected to the wires, and so if we give it a bit of a spin, yes, it produces a current. Even though the machine is very crunchy, it's not a bad attempt for my first one, my first attempt. Well, that was a fun project at least. Lots of precision issues. That's probably more of an adornment than an engineering useful object. But anyway, it was I learned a lot on some of the engineering things, and there's lots to learn about more precision and things like that. And in future ones, we're going to make simpler things too, but at least it did work. Not bad for having been done totally by hand. Thank you.